so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh,
that is set. Looks like Eddie Hawker from the Chorister team is here with 8 up. Diesel, two-wheel drive.
Pulling air to the begin to line up in the starting line, please. Stop.
Thank you. character, number two, Eddie Hawker.
There's Eddie right there in the shades.
Say, Will.
Say, Jason.
How are you?
I'm good.
W250. Stay with your vehicle, please. All right, looks like Scott Beal. Marston Road, New Windsor. Got a white Ford F-250. Done this before. 1994. I'll send him back to driving school. Alrighty. Henry's back out here for his second attempt. His first attempt was 193.41. Let's see if he played the odd finger right. Different Rebel sleds did Mr. Stahl build and have here in Carroll County? How many sleds did Mr. Stahl have over the years and built? And the first couple was built in the Walkersville Ag Shop where he taught school. Taught ag there, and kids helped build the first sled. So how many sleds did he build? And I take no phone calls and text messages. You gotta come to the stage. And the track crew doesn't help.
Bradley Owens. Bradley Owens.
Alrighty, we got a winner on our trivia question. It was three sleds. The very first original sled was the Heartbreaker. Alrighty, Bradley Owens. Official Mr. Chester Stems that they are going to reset the sled one more time. We got 17 in this class, so they don't want them all going into downtown Westminster, so they're going to try to shut them down here a little bit more. Our next truck coming out is Randy Johnson with a Mack CL713. He was out here earlier today in the races and was up in the Show and Shine Show. Hails out of Cambridge, Maryland, down on the Eastern Shore. I'm sure we'll see him next Friday night. The Straddling Microphone will be at the Tuckahoe Steam and Gas Association, the East Coast Pool down there next Friday.
Okay.
Sled down another good looking Kenworth. White Pine Paving, Brian Mann, Hempstead, Maryland.
Thank you.
coming out on the track now is Mr. Mark Turner. And you talk about Southern Maryland. He tails out of Chaptico. And that is right down about, you get your feet wet when you walk in the post office down there.
Thank you.
Alrighty. Back then to the sled nails. Robbie Hungerford. With a 1986 Autocar 1864 and a 400 Cummins at 13 speed. Upper Eastern Shore, Dudley Corner Road. running a 1986 Ford CL9000. That is one sharp looking old Ford Cavalier. Now is Mr. Jamie Eason, Cordova, Maryland, 1996, Peterbilt 377. Mr. Kugel has scratched because the hitch will not adapt to his truck, so he is a scratch. We are going to move into our hot street semis. Move into our hot street semis. Mr. Brian Smith bringing the Superliner out here. Always a good running truck. Mr. Brian Smith on the Superliner Mac, always a good running truck. Got the big V8 in there. Turbos on it. Truck he calls Nova. Slid down is Mr. Frank Fleming and the old mule, 1973 International S model with a deep V92 Detroit Allison automatic. Is back here in the hot class with his 96 Peterbilt 377. 186.66, 186.66 for Mr. Johnson. And they scratched that truck, so that's the end of our street semis. So all stock dump trucks be getting them lined up for our hot street semis. Brian Smith was snowblind to Mac, 217.09. Second went to Jamie Eason with the 96 Peterbilt 377 and 19074. Third went to Randy Johnson in the Max CL 713, 186.6. And fourth went to Jamie Eason 77 Ford with 185.46. And fifth went to Frank Fleming, 1973 International S model. The sled now. So like Brian Pan, White Pine Paving, Hampstead, Maryland. The Ribbon Runner for Breast Cancer Awareness. Brian Pan, Hampstead, Maryland.
Nice run for the truck. 86.55.
gonna drop that hook and come back. Friday night the 28th for another big farm stock and interstate pool to lead off the Carroll County Fair here in 2 weeks on July 28th. Plenty of stuff to do the following week here at the fair. They have a bunch of trucks and equipment in here on Tuesday night for the touch truck event. Horse pull will be Wednesday night. The skid steer rodeo will be Thursday night, livestock auction Friday night, our car demolition derby will be the last Saturday night, August the 5th. Back up to Saturday the 29th will be grain truck racing out here along with the pickups and ATVs again. So plenty of events coming up here in 2 weeks at the Carroll County 4-H FFA Fair. Just like sitting in the quarry waiting on a load. All right, Matthew Williams out of Leonardtown, Maryland. On the 01 Peterbilt 379 with the Caterpillar. Please. Thank you. Williams here running in this class yet, and then we'll be done our dump trucks.
Hold up. Hey! Hey!
like Mario D'Angelo, 2012 Ford F-250. Big event over in Easton, Maryland. All right, looks like we got Jeremy Romich out of Rocky Ridge with a 13 Ford F-350.
Thank you.
17123 for Dakota.
Thank you.
here comes the last man out, Mr. Alan Casey, Cabletown, West Virginia, right outside of Charlestown. Go four. Green light, green flag. Last truck out, Casey. And every one of you. We'll see you back here in 2 weeks, July 28th, for the big interstate turnstile pole to lead off the 2023 Carroll County Fair.